I'm also the granddaughter of a man who was too young to join the New Zealand Army, so he came and joined the Australian Army. And he went with the Australian Army to the Somme, and he was gassed. But he still came home and married his sweetheart, and they introduced my mother. So I'm the NZ and Anzac. And if it wasn't for NZ, you'd just be ARC. And for years, for over a century, New Zealanders and Australians have been side by side, fighting other men's wars in other parts of the world, not our wars, not in our name. And it makes me really sad that we haven't learned from those 100 years, that we haven't learned that it's not okay to go over to the other side of the world and to bomb other women's children. War is not the answer, my friends here. We are here to learn the ways of peace, conflict resolution, diplomacy, reconciliation, forgiveness, healing. War doesn't produce anything good for anybody. And not only that, it doesn't make our country safe. Being a part of the American alliance makes our countries unsafe because it makes America's enemies our enemies, and it makes our people vulnerable. And none of us want that. We all want to live in peace. So, on this beautiful morning outside Canberra, we have come to ask for peace, to stop the killing. The billions and billions of dollars that go into this military machine should be used for feeding people, for clothing people, for housing people, for educating people, for teaching us the ways of peace. We need to put down our weapons. And I tell you what, we don't want to put you guys out of a job, you guys and women. I tell you what, there's a lot of work to do now. Building sustainability, dealing with climate change. You know, we've just been seeing amazing conditions, weather conditions. I've just been up in northern New South Wales. There was terrible flooding up there, and terrible, terrible flooding. You know, cafes in Lismore have been closed down. They'll never be reopened because people can't afford to. And when I left home on Good Friday, we just suffered from cyclone Cook. And there was 150 km/h wind. There were trees falling down all over Hawke's Bay where I live. And that takes a lot of work rebuilding. So you guys who are so skilled in civil defence and have so many skills in engineering and building things and creating safe spaces, you could put those energies towards helping people and rebuilding our environment. And also the money that's spent on stupid weapons could be used for creating sustainable sources of energy, the things that we really, really need. We could put in that money towards solar paneling and wind energy and electric cars and just the things we really, really need, all of us, let alone housing refugees. You know, the war has created and famine has created 65 million refugees in this world. It's like a world record. It's a terrible world record. And countries like ourselves, who are lands of plenty, and who our ancestors came to over the last century or two, we should be opening our doors to these people in need who have their land and their homes bombed by our allies bombed. They need a home, and if we don't, can't create hope for these poor, poor, innocent, suffering civilians, families, children, women, old men, old women, if we can't create homes for these people, what is